Hey guys, so I'm going to be showing you my March favorites. I've kind of wanted to say April, but April barely started. I mean, it's like the 6th or the 5th. I don't even know. I only keep track of my dates when I'm in school. And right now, I am barely starting spring break and I'm not going to do anything because I'm such a lowlife. And I'm a 20-year-old lowlife. I have nothing better to do than just stay home. So some of the products that I've been loving are basically just makeup and also for my hair. As you can tell, I recently changed the hair color and my hair is overprocessed. I will be recording a video on my hair, what happened, what I did and stuff, and how I'm restoring it. So either it should be up or subscribe if you're barely watching this and you guys could see it. So the first product that I've been liking, I haven't been into skincare a lot just because I've been keeping the same skincare routine, but for makeup, I've been loving the Hourglass Mineral Veil. It's a primer, and it's just like not a silicone based, but it's just very smooth. It makes your makeup stay on the entire day, which I love because when I go to school, I go the entire day, and it stays on like nothing ever touched my face, like not even the air. I've also been loving this Glamouflage Hard Candy Concealer, and this is in the shade Medium. I basically use this on my face instead of using a foundation. I just dab on a little bit and just cover up some of the hyperpigmentation that I got going on, and it works wonders. It's been compared to the Kat Von D concealer, I forgot what it's called, but it's very creamy and it covers up imperfections like crazy. I've also been liking the Stay Matte by Rimmel, and this, I always get this one. It's in Sandstorm, and I've hit pan, and it makes me stay matte on my T-zone because I'm very oily on my T-zone. I don't have a very, very oily skin, but it's just like on my T-zone. And I've been also liking this NYC Smooth Skin Bronzer, and this is in Sunny. Everyone talks about it. I've always used the Hoola bronzer, but I recently discovered this, and I really like it, how it contours and it doesn't look that muddy. And it's a little bit lighter than Hoola by Benefit. I think it's Benefit, yeah. So make sure to check this out. It's only like $3. I've also been liking this Black Radiance Golden Shimmer Bronzer, but I don't use this to contour. I just use this a light side and I use it as blush. I've been really liking the natural look, so I just put on my concealer, powder, and then I contour, and then I put the light color on the apples of my cheeks, and it gives me like this dewy look, sort of summery. But I've been really into that, so that's what I've had been wearing the entire month of March. But the beginning of March, I was wearing this rose petal cream blush from NYX, and it just looks like this. And I don't know why the camera does this, but it's picking it up orange, and it's not orange. Believe me, it just looks like this. It's like a very peachy toned color, very subtle, not so bright. And for lip products, I've been loving basically NYX products. I've been loving the Soft Matte Lip Cream in Antwerp and the Butter Gloss in Peach Cobbler. So this is what they look like in the package. And I had already done swatches earlier prior to this. And sorry, I feel like I'm rushing, but it's just I need to go to mass right now. It's just this like very soft pink color, but also corally. It just looks like this. And then the one in Peach Cobbler, the Butter Gloss, it's very glossy. I love it because I'm not a person that wears much lip gloss just because it's very sticky. I don't know. I'm more of a lipstick person, but this is what it looks like. It sort of looks similar to this one, and it looks more vibrant, but that's actually what I'm wearing on my lips today. I don't know if you guys could really see it because it's sort of wearing off, but it's not so sticky. It's the perfect consistency. It doesn't make my lips stick to each other, and it's very natural in a way. And for eye products, I've been loving this Rimmel Lash Accelerator Endless, and according to this product, your lashes are supposed to sort of grow. I wouldn't really know if my eyelashes have been growing just because My eyelashes are naturally long, so I don't know if my eyelashes have been growing or not, or if it's helping at all. But what I do know is that it makes my lashes look super long. I mean, any other mascara really does it, but this one, I feel like it also separates them, volumizes them, and I love it, and it's only a couple of bucks. And that's it for makeup. What I've been loving from my hair, like I said, I went through like this whole phase with my hair, and it's very damaged so far. So I've been loving the Josie Maran Argan Oil. I swear by this. I use it on my face, on my skin, on my hands. It leaves it super, super soft. I usually put this on my face overnight, and it works wonders. And also put it on my hair when it's damp and when it's dry, just to like give it a little bit of a shine and also like make it softer. And I've also been loving this Macadamia Natural Oil Healing Oil Treatment. That's a mouthful, but it smells amazing. It sort of smells like guy cologne. Yeah, sort of. But it's so moisturizing for the hair. So yeah. Oh no, one more thing. The fragrance that I've been loving, I mean, even though I'm 20, I'm supposed to be wearing perfumes and not little girl scents, but I've been loving this Cotton Candy Girly Girl fragrance. It smells amazing. I actually got the pack of this over the holiday season, and it just smells like cotton candy. Very sweet, but once you put it on, it's very like a light scent, so it's not that overpowering. But yeah, that is it for my favorites. I didn't have song favorites or app favorites. At least not that I could think of, but that is it. I will see you guys in my next video. Make sure to subscribe and like, comment, and all that good stuff on YouTube, you know? So, like I said, I will see you guys next time. Bye, guys.